Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to install MinGW compiler in a Windows 10 operating system. Now, as you know that MinGW is a very popular compiler for C and C++ program, but as you know that recently this MinGW.org website is not opening. So you can check that MinGW.org. So in this video, what I'll be doing is I'll be showing you a new way to download this MinGW compiler in your Windows 10 operating system. So for that, just cancel this and in here just type MinGW compiler, then just enter. And now the first thing you will get this sourceforge.net. So just simply click on this MinGW minimalistic GNU for Windows download. So just click on that. So basically we are going to download this MinGW from this SourceForge website. So now in here, just click on this download. It will show you your download will start shortly. So just wait 4 to 5 seconds. And now as you can see, this MinGW setup wizard has been rightly downloaded. So just open the folder. And now as you can see in this download directory, this MinGW setup wizard has been rightly there. So just double click on it to install, and now just minimize this download directory. And now in here, as you can see, this MinGW installation manager setup tool has been rightly launched. Now just simply click on install, and this is basically the directory where this MinGW going to be installed. So if you want to change your installation directory, then you can just simply click on change and you can change your installation directory. But I will, you know, keep this all default and then simply click on continue. And now as you can see, it's showing that connecting to, you know, pr/downloads.sourceforge.net. So basically you need to have an active internet connection right throughout the installation. As you can see, this downloading is currently in progress. So I will just simply fast forward it and come back when it gets done. And now we'll, you know, simply click on continue. And now in here, in this MinGW installation manager, they basically gave you these options to install. So for which, you know, I will be clicking mark for installation, then mark for installation. Just right click on it and then just mark for installation. Now just go to this installation and then just simply click on this apply changes. And now in here, just simply click on apply. And now as you can see, this basically downloading is progress. So it will take a minute or two. As I have already mentioned earlier, you need to have an active internet connection right throughout the installation. So it will take a minute or two. So for which, you know, I will come back once when it gets done. So welcome back. And now as you can see, this downloading has been rightly completed and the files are now getting extracted and going to be installed. So you know, again I will come back once when it gets done. So now as you can see that these all changes are applied successfully. So now you can simply close this wizard, and again you can close this, and now just simply click on this command prompt, and in here type G++ space --- version. Now even after this MinGW installation, it is showing that G++ is not recognized as an internal or an external command. Now this is because this environment path has not been shared. So for that, just simply close that and then just go to your C directory, and in here you can see that this MinGW has been installed over here. So just click on that and then go to this bin directory, and now just go to this address bar, and here if you type cmd then enter, and now if you type G++ space --- version, you will see that G++, that is this MinGW.org GCC 6.3.0 has been rightly installed, but it's not showing in that directory. That's because as I have mentioned earlier, the environment path has not been shared. So now you just simply, you know, copy this path. So just simply Ctrl C and then go to this search icon, and here type environ. And now just click on this edit system environment variables. And now you will see this pop-up from this system properties. Now just simply click on these environment variables. And now under this system variable, just click on path and then edit. And now you will see this edit environment variable will pop up. So now just simply click on new. And in here, just simply paste by simply Ctrl V. And now as you can see that this MinGW/bin folder has been rightly printed. Just simply click on OK. Then again OK. Then again OK. And now if you just close this and again open your command prompt. And now you are basically in your home directory, right? And now if you just simply type G++\version. And now just enter. And now as you can see that this mingw.org 6.3.0 has been rightly shown in our home directory as well. So now we just know that this environment path has been rightly set. And now I will also tell you how to use this compiler. Now many of my students are already asking that sir, how to run our C program in a command prompt. So I will also going to show that. And now that you install your compiler, now it's time to write some C program. So just click on the search icon, then type notepad, and in here you will type a simple C program, simple C hello world program, let's say. So hash include stdio.h, and now just simply int main, and now in here just simply print if. Hello world, and now just simply return 0, and now just save this file by clicking Ctrl S, and now in here just create a new folder C_programs. Just go inside that directory, and in here we'll save this file. First click this save as type, and then click this all files, and in here save the file as frog1.c. you need to save this file as a .c extension. If you want to code in C++, you can you need to save this file as .cpp extension. And here I wrote a simple wrote a program in C, so I'll save this as a frog1.c, and now just simply click on save. And now as you can see that this program has been saved as this prog1. And now I'll show you how you can run your C program from this command prompt. So just first close this, and now just go to your directory where you have saved your file. So just I have saved under this document, then this C programs. So here basically our C program file. And now in here just go to this address bar and type cmd to open your command prompt under this directory. This is a very simple way to open a command prompt in this directory. Just go to that address bar and just simply type cmd, and you will get your command prompt open on under this directory. There's also one trick. And now in here just type gcc prog1.c. Now just simply click on enter. And now as you can see that a file generated naming A. Now just simply type A and enter. And as you can see, this hello world has been rightly prompted. Now here this output has been generated by naming A. If you get some different program name, you might get some different name as well. So for that you need to run the file by typing this file name. So here the file name came is A. So I run this program by typing simply A, and the output has been directly shown hello world. So in this way you can run your C program or C++ program as well in this command prompt. And also I have also shown you how to install a MinGW compiler in your Windows 10 operating system, as this MinGW .org website is currently not opening. So I have also shown you an alternative way how to download this MinGW compiler to run your C and C++ program. So that's all for this video, friends. If you like this video, then please do give it a thumbs up, and also please do share with your friends. This is a very useful video, especially for the new programmers who want to, you know, code your program in C or C++. So that's all for this video, friends. Please do subscribe our channel, and also please do share with your friends. So once again, thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.